Well, this is our devotional for November 3rd. We're continuing through the book of James, chapter 1. And today we're looking at chapter 1 of James, verses 26 and 27. So just kind of quiet your heart. You might be in the middle of a busy day. Just kind of quiet your heart and listen to God's word. Let him speak to you. Those who consider themselves religious and yet do not keep a tight rein on their tongues deceive themselves, and their religion is worthless. Religion that God our Father accepts as pure and faultless is this: to look after orphans and widows in their distress and to keep oneself from being polluted by the world. There's a lot there, but there's kind of one heartbeat, one big theme, and that is kind of what is true and God-honoring religion. Religion for religion's sake is a waste of time. There's all kinds of religions, and they demand all kinds of things of people. There's do's and don'ts. But it's about a relationship with God, the living God that transforms us and transforms the world, that brings God the greatest delight. So in this passage, we see a number of things. First of all, you know, what is worthless religion? And what James says is it's a religion that has no control, particularly over the things a person says. Those who consider themselves religious and do not keep a tight rein on their tongues deceive themselves, and their religion is worthless. Again, James has just said, you need to be a doer of the word, not just a hearer. Now he's saying, so if you just are religious, but it doesn't change who you are, your character, your heart, how you speak, then is your religion really worth anything? And he's saying, no, it's just a kind of a false repetition of religious ideas, but it's not a transformed life. And then he says, there is pure and good religion. Yes, it's possible. Some people say, oh, I hate religion. Religion is bad. Well, no, it's not. It can be. But a true faith in God, passion for him, and a transformed life is a religious expression of faithfulness. And so he gives a picture of what that looks like. And ultimately, what James is saying is this. Here's how a transformed heart and life looks. Instead of a mouth that won't shut up, it's hands that won't stop caring and serving. He says, people who will look after the broken, the forgotten, the powerless. In the ancient world, that was orphans and widows. That's not always the case anymore. Someone can be a widow and be very well off and very established and not need the kind of compassionate help that other people might need. They have a heart that needs to be cared for, but they, in the ancient world, widows and orphans were poor. They were forgotten. They were not just on the margins of the society. They were pushed off the map. And James is saying, if you've walked with Jesus, if you know that he loves you with grace, if you've been transformed by him, then you will care with the heart of Jesus. You'll see the broken, the forgotten, the outcast, the hurting, and your heart will beat with the heart of Jesus, and you'll care for them. You'll make a difference. And then James goes on to say, don't be polluted by the world. So let Jesus transform your heart and love people with compassion and make sure the pollution of the world, and there's plenty of it, of all kinds, isn't infiltrating your heart and your mind. Keep your hands, you know, here's the picture. Keep your mouth shut when it comes to saying negative things. Be careful with what you say. Keep your hands busy helping and serving the broken and the hurting. And keep your heart engaged with God and closed off to the junk, to the pollution that can go flowing in from the world. That's a lot in one passage, but if you'll take that passage, meditate on it, go back and read it a couple times today, think about it, and say, God, I want to be able to see and notice those who are hurting and broken and marginalized and have the heart of Jesus toward them. And then guard my heart from the junk that's kind of floating around in our culture and be careful I become the person God wants me to be. Lord, this is our prayer, that we would be people who, we don't care, Lord, that so much that we're religious, but we want to make sure that our faith expression reflects your heart, gives you glory, and makes us the kind of people who are agents of change in a world that desperately needs, Jesus, what you want to bring to them. So fill us with your spirit and your power and lead us forward, we pray in your name. Amen. Well, God bless you. That's the end of James chapter 1. Our next devotional, we'll jump into James chapter 2. We'll see you Sunday at 9 and 11 for worship at Shoreline. God bless you. Have a great rest of your week.